there are no others, then let us begin our worship by joining together in our choral introit. Lord, listen to your children pray.
Thank you. she opened her eyes, and then seeing Peter, she sat up. He gave her his hand and helped her up, and then calling the saints and widows, he showed her to be alive. This became known throughout Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. And meanwhile, he stayed at Joppa for some time with a certain Simon, a tanner. Dear God, thank you for letting us hear your word today in this extraordinary miracle, and let us be open to miracles in our lives.
Amen.
For those who need to hear it, happy Mother's Day. For those who cannot hear it, happy Sabbath. For those who don't know where they stand, may we all find grace in this space. I never know what to do on days like this. In some ways, it feels a little strange, when Mike and I chose to get married, we're blessed with the ability to choose that we were never going to have children. Now, coming in as a young pastor to a church where they had a young pastor and a seminary fiance, they were sure that we were going to be making children for their Sunday school, and I think after 11 years, you all have kind of caught on that that wasn't going to happen. So you all were very wonderful when you just allowed us to accept furballs as the closest thing we have for children. And so I got the name Mother when I took on a guinea pig, because for some reason, anytime Mike would do little things around the house, he talked to the guinea pig and called me Mom. And when the guinea pig passed away, it wasn't long after that we got our dog, Aglaya. And then after unfortunate encounters on the road, we ended up with a cat. Both have passed away in the past few months, and suddenly, for the first time in a few years, I suddenly have this thought of, well, am I still a mom? Which is the silliest thing, because I've never in a moment taken that title from anyone. When it comes to being able to create life, there's no test that you're given to give you approval for such a thing. In fact, sometimes it seems a little mind-boggling who gets the gift and who doesn't, who chooses the gift and who doesn't, and yet here we are in our odd complexity as human beings. And then Peter walks in and gives us yet another miracle, a recreation, a rebirth, a resurrection. Resurrections happen a few times in the Bible, and often we miss them because we only think of Jesus' resurrection or maybe Lazarus' resurrection, but there are a number of times when the prophets or the apostles will resurrect another person. And when these resurrections happen, it is not because they stumble on this person alone. It is because a community has called them to the space. Here, Peter is summoned to the bedside of Tabitha so that he can call upon her to get up and open her eyes and watch her go back into her mysteries. And he calls on the community to see the wonders of God. There are many times when we will gather and we will celebrate a new birth baby, and then there are times when we struggle to figure out how do we deal with the disappointment that comes in loss. Too often we leave an empty void
forth stronger than before.
We have the bronze plates